Welcome to the Lightspeed Restaurant Getting Started video guide for K-Series. I'm Vinny, here to help you set up your point of sale hardware. This video will cover three key pieces of hardware that most businesses use daily: printers, cash drawers, and payment terminals. We'll outline the basic steps to physically set up each device, and then we'll show you how to connect it to Lightspeed Restaurant. There are a variety of models that work with Lightspeed, so your setup steps may vary depending on which version of the hardware you have. If you need more detailed help, you can find written setup guides on our Help Center for supported models, or you can follow the manufacturer's documentation. But before you start setting up your hardware, there are a couple of things you'll need to do first. Begin by making sure you have a reliable network and internet connection at your business. This will allow your hardware to communicate with your POS and your POS to communicate with the back office. At minimum, you should have a dedicated router for your Lightspeed hardware, so that all of your Lightspeed devices are connected to a network that's reserved for them alone. There are other best practices you should follow to optimize your network for Lightspeed Restaurant, so look for a link to our Help Center article on that topic in the description below. You'll also want to turn on your iPad and complete the initial setup wizard before installing your hardware. We'll talk more about setting up your iPad in another video, but for now, just make sure it's powered on. Now, let's talk hardware, beginning with printers. To get started, plug your printer into a power outlet, load its paper in the correct orientation required for your model, and if you're using an impact printer, install the ink ribbon. You'll also have to connect the printer to your network or to a POS device according to its connection type. If you're using a LAN or USB printer, it's important to do that before powering it on. But if you have a Bluetooth or Wi-Fi model, you'll configure its network settings after turning it on. LAN models use an Ethernet cable to connect to your router. USB models connect directly to your iPad with a USB cable. Bluetooth models pair through your iPad settings after you put them in pairing mode. And Wi-Fi printers normally use a special app or protocol to connect with your network. With your printer physically installed, you'll need to add it to the back office to continue the setup process. Log into the back office, go to Configuration on the sidebar, and select Printing, Printers. Then click Add Printer. Enter a recognizable name for the printer, like Counter Receipt Printer or Grill Ticket Printer. Then select your printer's model from the driver drop-down menu. The model you choose will determine what other information is required in order to add the printer. For example, if you're using a LAN or Wi-Fi printer, you'll have to enter its IP address or its hardware address. You can find that information by printing a self-test page from the printer. To print a self-test page, turn the printer off, hold both the power and feed buttons, and release when printing begins. If that doesn't work, check your printer's manual for the appropriate steps. On the self-test printout, you'll find the printer's IP address and its MAC address. The MAC address is what Lightspeed calls the hardware address. In the back office, enter the printer's IP address or its hardware address in the relevant field. Using the IP address is more reliable, but only if you know how to take the right precautions to avoid IP conflicts on your network. MAC address setup is much simpler since you don't need to perform any extra steps, but it's only available with certain printers. Please visit the links in our description below for more information on both types of setups. Click Save to finish adding your printer. Next, let's set up your cash drawer. If you're planning to open your cash drawer manually using its key, simply set the drawer on a countertop. But if you want the cash drawer to be able to open automatically from the POS, you'll need to connect it to the receipt printer. To do that, plug the larger end of the cable included with the cash drawer into the port on the bottom of the drawer. The smaller end plugs into your receipt printer. Ensure the drawer's lock is in the vertical position so it's unlocked for automatic opening. Then you'll need to add the cash drawer to your back office to enable drawer tracking and automatic opening. Note that once created, a cash drawer cannot be deleted. Let's log into the back office, go to Configuration on the sidebar, and select Devices, Cash Drawers. Then click Create New Cash Drawer. Fill in a name for the cash drawer to identify it. For example, Counter Drawer. And click OK to finish creating the drawer and return to the Cash Drawers page. Now you'll need to click Edit next to the drawer to configure its settings. In the Physical Drawer section, select the printer you've connected to the drawer. Below that, you'll see a few options for setting drawer counting to enabled, disabled, or mandatory, entering the initial cash amount for each shift, and allocating non-cash payments. In the final section, you can select which POS devices and user groups are able to use and manage the drawer. We'll revisit these connections in more detail in other Getting Started videos when we go over POS devices and user groups. Finally, let's talk about setting up your Lightspeed Payments payment terminal. It's important to only use the terminal supplied to you by Lightspeed. Terminals obtained from a third party may not be correctly configured for your account and could be a security risk. To start setting up your terminal, you may need to plug it into a power outlet to charge before turning it on. Depending on your specific model, you may also need to load a roll of paper, follow prompts on the terminal's screen to connect it to Wi-Fi, or complete other physical setup steps. With your terminal powered on, you'll need to pair it with Lightspeed Payments and assign it to a POS device or payment method. There's a link in the description below to a separate video playlist that will guide you through that process, as well as the entire setup process for your specific payment terminal. Of course, there are other types of hardware than the three we've discussed in this video. You may also be setting up a barcode scanner, order display system, kitchen display system, or other hardware that you've purchased from Lightspeed. Check our help center or the links in the description below for resources on setting up any of these devices. And that's our starter guide to setting up your hardware. Until the next video, if you have any questions, just visit our K-Series Help Center.